Radio KOFN, 1313 AM, The Coffin. Radio KOFN, 1313 AM, The Coffin. All right, guys, welcome back to the Graveyard Shift. My name's Scott Nightshade, and I'll be your host this evening. Now, tonight, we're going to air an old-time radio show called Lights Out. Now, Lights Out aired between 1934 and about 1947. Now, the episode we have for you tonight is called Murder Castle, and it aired in about 1938. So go ahead and grab your drinks, grab your snacks, hold each other close, because you're about to enter Murder Castle.
I tell you, Captain, it don't make sense. We picked her up walking down the street saying the same thing over and over again. Well, she's as goofy as they come, I tell you. Listen to her yourself.
Revenge.
Revenge. Yeah, listen to her, Captain. Revenge. Over and over again.
Revenge.
Such a young and pretty girl.
Revenge.
What could have driven her out of her mind like
revenge.
That, I ask you?
Revenge.
What is it?
I'm looking for a Mr. Henry Stewart, if you please.
Oh, you mean about the advertisement?
Yes, that's right. I got here as soon as I could.
That's all right, as long as you got here, that's all that matters. Come in.
Oh, thank you.
Just put your suitcase down there. It'll be all right.
Thank you.
Now, if you'll come out this way.
Thank you.
Just step in here, Miss...
Malone. Ella Malone.
Oh, yes, of course. Miss Malone. Now then, you'll have a chair, please.
Oh, thank you.
There we are. Now then, Miss Malone, to be perfectly frank with you, I wasn't quite expecting you today.
Oh, I'm truly sorry, Mr. Stewart. But you see, I took the wrong train and Well, I had the hardest time finding the house. I do hope you'll forgive me.
Of course. Don't give it another thought. Promptness may be a virtue, but we all can't be virtuous, now can we? Now then, you're here in answer to my advertisement.
Yes, sir. You wrote me.
Oh, yes, of course. You're the young lady from...
From Queensville.
Oh, yes, Queensville. You have my letter with you?
Oh, yes, sir. Right here, sir.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Now then, your friends know you came here, of course.
There's no one very much interested, Mr. Stewart.
Oh, come now. A pretty young girl like you, no young beaux, and so on, so on.
No, sir, there's no one. I mean, sir, you can depend on me to give all my attention to my work.
Very commendable indeed. My work, as I wrote you, is entirely confidential. My philanthropies are, to a great extent, entirely sub rosa, no fuss, no feathers. You understand what I mean?
Oh, yes, sir.
As my secretary, my affairs will be entirely in your hands. My checking account, my finances, and so on. Entirely in your care.
I understand, sir.
It's quite a responsibility, and you're quite a young woman. And as I wrote you, the bank...
Oh, yes, sir, I understand. The bond, I brought the money for it, $300. Uh-huh. I've got it right here, sir.
Oh, fine. That's very businesslike, yes, indeed. I'll give you a receipt, and there we'll be.
Mr. Stewart.
Yes? Oh, my pen. Oh, yes, here we are.
My money. Will I get it back from the bank any time I leave your employ? I mean, when you want me to.
Hmm? Yes, of course. Now then, here we are. Received of Miss Nellie Malone.
Ella.
Oh, yes, of course, Ella. Memory isn't quite what it used to be. That's why I need a good secretary.
I'm very good at remembering things.
Oh, you are. Now then, here we are. Guess this receipt is in good order. Received of Miss Ella Malone. $300 to be deposited with the Merchants Bank as surety bond, and to be returned to said Ella Malone upon request. There's my signature. Now then, how's that?
I'm sure that'll do very well, sir.
Now, you have got my receipt, but I...
I beg your pardon.
Not at all.
Of course, I have it right here. I am sorry.
Oh, well, I understand. The excitement of your trip.
Here it is, Mr. Stewart. You see, I had it already in an envelope. Now, if you'll open it...
Oh, no, not at all. Ben can do that when I send it to them in the morning. Now, just put your purse down there, and I'll show you through your new home.
Yes, Mr. Stewart.
Now, we'll go right up these stairs.
Yes, sir.
Oh, yes, you find I have quite a place here. Three stories high, and every inch of it my own design.
Rather dark.
Careful now.
Oh, I'm all right.
Mustn't hurt yourself. Hardly the way to start a new job. Now then, here we are. Got a nice room for you, very nice. Fact of the matter is, you can choose any room on this floor.
But, Mr. Stewart, your daughters...
Daughters?
Yes, won't they object? You said anything.
Oh, yes, my daughters. I did write to you about them, didn't I?
Yes, you did.
Well, never mind about them. They're upstairs studying. Now, right here. I suggest that you take this room, at least for tonight.
Whatever you say, Mr. Stewart.
Get the light on. There we are. Nice, isn't it?
I've never had such a large room. If you've got one a little smaller...
On the contrary, my dear Miss Malone, you'll find this one small enough. Perhaps a little too small. Yes, indeed. Entirely too small.
But, Mr. Stewart... Locking the door. Mr. Stewart, why did you lock the door? Mr. Stewart, why have you shut me in here? Mr. Stewart, please. Please answer me. Mr. Stewart, please let me out of here.
Yes, Miss Nora. There's no doubt in my mind at all that you're the very person I want to employ as my housekeeper.
I'm very glad to hear that, Mr. Stewart.
Of course, the matter of being housekeeper of a place as large as mine calls for definite qualities, you understand, of course.
I'll always do my best, sir.
Well, one certainly can't ask for more than that, no, indeed.
Your wife, maybe she'd like to talk to me?
My wife? Oh, yes, of course. I wrote you about my wife, didn't I?
Yes, sir.
Well, my wife is out shopping. As soon as she returns, you will meet her. I'm sure she'll find your recommendations as satisfactory as I did.
Makes me very happy. I've always wanted to work in a fine house.
Now, about money.
Oh, any salary you want to pay me, Mr. Stewart, is all right. I just want a chance to show you how good I can do your work.
Very commendable, yes, indeed, very commendable. But we must agree on a salary. I'm the sort of man who has respect for money and expects a similar respect in others. Oh, yes, and speaking of money, you'll be wanting to open a new bank account, I suppose.
Bank account?
Yes, it's my principle that everyone employed by me should have a savings account. Builds character. I'll open an account for you in the morning. You can transfer any of the bank accounts you have back in your hometown up to my bank. Convenience, you know.
Oh, no, sir. I haven't got that.
Hmm?
I haven't any money in the bank back home. I took it all out.
Oh.
It wasn't much anyway. I got what was left of father's insurance money after my mother died.
Oh, yes. Well, now then, supposing you leave all your things here and we'll go look over the house, hmm?
That'll be very nice. Mm.
Here, right through this door.
I'd be glad to be working in such a big house.
Right this way. Oh, yes, quite an establishment here. Designed it all myself.
I'll work hard, Mr. Stewart.
Oh, yes, I'm certain you will. Now then, right down these stairs. I'll show you everything downstairs first.
You have a washing machine?
Huh? Oh, yes, everything modern, everything convenient. High, wide basement. There you are. Now, watch yourself. It's just a little dark down here this time of day.
Oh, it is a big basement, all right. Could hang up plenty of washing down here.
Oh, yes, indeed. Now, if you'll just come this way.
You building something down here?
Building? Oh, yes, indeed. Always building, always changing, always remodeling. Change. My hobby, always changing things.
Hard to keep clean.
Now, don't you worry about that. Everything will be cleaned up in short order. The bags of sand, concrete mixer, everything will be out of the way. Won't bother you at all. No, not at all. Now, right this way.
You're making more rooms?
Oh, yes. Yes, indeed. With nice, clean, concrete floors. Here. Look at this one.
It's kind of dark.
Oh, come on, come on. Get closer. All my own work. You see, the floor is still wet. I like concrete, don't you?
Yes, it is clean.
Yes. Covers everything. You know how deep that concrete is? 3 feet deep. Yes, ma'am, 3 feet deep. And I just poured it an hour before you honored me with your presence. 3 feet. That'll make a mighty thick slab of stone, won't it, Miss Nord? Thick enough to cover you. Yes, indeed. A fist to the point of the jaw is still a most effective soporific. You're quite a light woman, my dear Miss Nord. Up you go, and in you go. Face down. What an unusual bed you lie in, Miss Nord. Sinking down and down and down. And the concrete will harden. And I guess I will have to get myself a new housekeeper.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's lean back now and relax for a moment. Let's take time out from tonight's amazing Lights Out story. The story of a strange, mysterious mansion and the one woman who entered those doors and was never seen alive again. Let's turn during this brief intermission to a much more everyday situation and a question that's much easier to answer. An angry girl is storming out of her friend's house. And her friend says,
"What can be wrong with Lucy these days? She crosses a bear and she's losing so much weight she looks terrible. She's just no fun anymore."
"Well, you know what that well-known nutrition authority says about how improper eating due to wartime living may cause a person to become deficient in vitamin B1 and iron, and how you absolutely need enough of them to keep your right weight and energy."
"Well, come to think of it, that was Ruth's trouble when she got so run down. So she took ionized yeast tablets. And you know how grand she looks and feels again now."
Yes, friends, any number of people who, due to vitamin B1 and iron shortage, were losing weight, losing strength and energy and interest in life, tell how ionized yeast tablets help them regain glorious pep and strength and needed pounds. So if you're short vitamin B1 and iron, don't wait. Go to your druggist this very night and say,
"A bottle of ionized yeast tablets, please."
And now back to our Lights Out story of Murder Castle.
Hello? Hello? Hello, is this the employment agency? This is Mr. Stewart. It's Henry Stewart. I'm interested in employing a nurse for my child. Someone preferably unattached who can live here with my wife and myself. No. Just send me their names, addresses, and references and so on. I'll send you a check for the services. My address is 424 East 7th. Yes, that's right. Just their names and addresses. Yes, I'll send you a check. Goodbye. Yes, I'll be there. Yes, what is it?
Is Mr. Stewart in?
Oh, yes, indeed. Won't you come in? I'm Mr. Stewart.
Thank you.
You're answering in regard to...
Take care of your position. You wrote me a letter.
Oh, yes, indeed. Won't you step in here, please?
Thank you.
Now, you sit there, I'll sit here. We'll get better acquainted. Put your suitcase down there in place, so... Now then, I'm afraid I didn't quite get your name.
Ray. Betty Ray. You wrote me.
Oh, yes, of course. I remember you distinctly. Now then, you have my letter to you just to sort of refresh my memory on the circumstances, don't you know?
Oh. Well, I'm sorry.
Eh?
I didn't bring it with me.
Oh. Well, then suppose you tell me a little more about yourself than all this happened. Mother and father see you off the train, I suppose?
Oh, no, sir. It's the way I wrote you, Mr. Stewart.
I'm quite alone.
Oh, yes. Well, but first there's the matter of the surety bond. I wrote you about that, didn't I?
Yes. Yes, you did.
Ah, yes, I felt quite certain of that.
Mr. Stewart, I was wondering...
Yes?
Have you had many secretaries?
Why do you ask that?
I want to know.
Why do you ask that question?
And what happens to them after you hire them? Tell me, what happens to them?
Young woman, just who are you?
My name is Betty Malone.
Malone?
Betty Malone. My sister Ella came here a month ago about a job, and I want to know where she is. Do you hear me? I want to know where she is.
I don't think I quite know what you're talking about.
Why do you lie to me? Why do you lie to me? She was here, she was.
Oh, then what makes you so sure?
A letter you wrote her, the first one. I waited a whole month, and then I came here. And as soon as I saw you, I thought something was wrong. And now I know there is. My sister Ella, where is she? You've got to tell me.
What if I tell you again that I don't know what you're talking about?
I'll go to the police. They'll make you tell the truth. I know she came here. I know she did. Why do you laugh? Why?
Because you're being a very foolish young lady. Very foolish indeed. There's no need to get excited. Of course your sister's here, and very happy too.
She's here?
Yes, yes, and very happy too.
So then take me to her. Please take me to her.
All right, all right. No need to get excited. Of course I'll take you to her. I intended to all along. I was just having a little joke with you.
Is she all right? Is she
all
right?
Of course, of course. Now then, come right along with me. Come right along with me. Right along with me. Yes, yes, she's right up here. Been with me for over a month.
Why didn't she write? Why didn't she tell me?
Now then, right down this hall, and you can ask her that for yourself.
This isn't a trick, is it?
My dear young lady, you have easily the most suspicious mind of anyone I've ever met. Why, I'm quite a helpless old man, and you always have recourse, as you put it, to the police. Here we are, right in this room. Well, go right in.
All right. Well, it's locked.
Well, knock on the door, and she'll open it for you.
Ella? Ella, it's Betty. Let me in, darling, it's Betty.
What do you know? She's asleep.
Ella, please, it's Betty, your sister Betty.
Well, now, she certainly is a tight sleeper.
But she can't be sleeping. Open the door. Please open the door.
All right, all right. No reason to get excited.
Quickly, open the door, quickly.
Now, don't excite yourself needlessly. Well, I'll go ahead. You open the door.
Ella, it's Betty. Ella, what?
Now then, my dear Betty, we understand each other clearly, don't we?
Ella. Dead.
Nothing like a complete understanding now, is there?
Ella. Dead.
Oh, it wasn't so difficult. I shut the door, sealed it, and nature took care of the rest.
Ella. Dead.
She died quite easily. Much easier than others.
Why?
You mean, why do I do it? It's a very simple explanation, young woman. This is my business. Yes, yes, my business. Some men make their fortunes in stocks, some bonds, some in business. And this is my business.
Why?
Why? Why? Why is any business conducted? Profit, my dear. And I've made quite a neat little profit. Oh, yes, and a very safe one, too.
You're dead.
Yes, and you're the very first to come wandering about looking for one of my customers. The first. And I assure you, the last. Oh, yes. 30 women have come in my front door.
Ella.
31, including you and Ella. Come on along.
No.
I'll tell you all about them. You'll find it most instructive. Yes, indeed. Now, come.
Don't hold my arm.
Oh, but I must. These collars, they twist and turn. Oh, yes, it's best I hold your arm. Get lost easily around this house. My most interesting house.
Where are you taking me?
Yes, there were 30 before you. Most interesting array. I used to read the want ads in small town papers, and then I'd write letters. Oh, most interesting letters. I needed a secretary, a housekeeper, a nurse, excellent salary, unusual accommodation.
Oh, I knew this had happened.
Indeed. And they brought all their worldly belongings with them, generally in a suitcase. A little here, a little there. Oh, why, sure, it's been most profitable. Now, in this room, for example...
No, don't open that door.
No, perhaps it would be better not to. The one in here came to be my housekeeper. Oh, let me see. How long ago was it? Oh, well, no matter. She came as a housekeeper, and after she went into a retirement in that room, I found in her suitcase such interesting bonds. Why, I tell you, my eyes fairly popped right from my head. Oh, yes. It's the uncertainty that makes my little business so very fascinating.
Killed 30 women.
Now, let's go down a little way now, down here. Don't make me pull you along.
Killed 30 women.
It wasn't difficult. Most women are such fools, anxious to believe what they want to believe.
I came here for life, and you gave me death.
Ah, you're the smart one. That's why I'm even bothering showing you my work. I never did the others. And showing you around won't do harm. You won't be talking long.
30 women died.
Now, in this room. Let me open it and show you.
No. No, don't make me look. No, please don't. No.
Oh, you see? There's no reason for excitement. Just an empty room. That's what she thought when she went in here. Then I pressed this button, so. And the floor flopped open as she stood on it, and down she went. Down, down, down. Guess into what? A pit of lime. Oh, yes, I tried out so many different ways of killing them. You wonder why they'll never find me out? Well, I'll tell you why. Because I'm much too smart for all of them. Oh, not perfect crimes. No, nothing infantile, but just cleverness in choosing the women I do my business with and an equal cleverness in doing away with them.
Yes, indeed.
Now then, what was I telling you? Oh, yes, yes, yes. Why, they'll never get me.
Ella, seeing you, it's done things in my head.
No corpus delicti. And if there is one, no evidence of violence. Ah, there, that's the secret.
Were you very frightened, sister?
Pearl of quicklime, there's no corpus delicti after that, I can tell you. Not when you bury them in a slab of concrete. Ah, yes, that's the secret.
I could only have been with you, little sister.
Now, this room, let me show it to you. I think this will be your room, my dear.
Were you frightened?
You see the door? Airtight. Airtight, yes, indeed. I'll open it. The room. Amazing sight, isn't it? No doors, no windows.
I could have helped you, Ella.
Now, I'll shut you up inside the room, then I'll close the door and press this button here like this. You hear that, little one? You hear that? Pumping, pumping, pumping. And guess what is pumping?
Ella, my head.
Air. You hear me? Pumping the air out of the room. Yes, that's clever, isn't it? You breathe, and soon there'll be nothing there to breathe, and then you'll die. And if the police do find your body, no mark of violence, nothing but asphyxiation. A most mysterious death, they'll say. In time, they'll decide it's all quite natural, embolism, heart attack. Oh, they'll think up a fancy name to clear their files. Yes, indeed, they always do.
It isn't right for him to live with it, Ella.
Now, first, off with the pump. Now, my dear, I think you'd better step inside quickly now so I can close the door and go about my other work. Quickly, I tell you.
No, wait.
Wait, wait for what?
I want to give you something.
What can you give me that doesn't belong to me already?
This.
Gun.
Get in there. Get in that room.
Gun. You had a gun in your purse all the time.
My father. I bought it for the man who... Ella. Get in there.
No. What are you going...
Get in there. I'll press the trigger. Get in there. I'll kill you.
No, don't. Don't. I'm an old harmless man. I was only fooling. I wouldn't hurt you for the world.
Revenge. Strike to revenge, isn't it, Ella? He said to press this button, Ella. The pump. It's running, Ella. Listen to it. It's killing him the way he killed you. It's right to revenge, isn't it, little sister? Fight to revenge. 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 Fight to revenge.
The air. It's going out. The air. Shut off that motor out there. You hear me? Shut off that motor. Pumping out the air. Pumping it out. The pipe. The air going out. I can't reach the pipe. Shut it off, you devil out there. Shut it off. It'll kill me. Kill me. I'm getting thinner already. Shut it off. I'll give you anything you want. Shut up, Ed. I can't die. I won't die. I'll tear the walls down. Let me out of here. Air. Man's got the web here. Let me out. Let me out. Well, my ear. Can't hear. Crumbs breaking. Blood in my mouth. My eyes. No air. Breathing. Air. Give me air. Breath of air. Air.
Revenge.
Yes, listen to her, Captain.
Revenge.
Over and over again.
Revenge.
Such a young and pretty girl.
Revenge.
What could have driven her out of her mind crazy like that?
Revenge.
What, I ask you?
Mr. Obler, and I suppose they all died happily ever after.
You put things so sweetly, Mr. Martin.
Mm-hmm.
The dark corners of the human mind are the deepest dark, I believe, of anything in the universe. Speaking of darkness, how would you like to turn back the pages of that nebulous stuff known as time to the Sakhalin of Tsarist Russia?
You mean right now, Mr. Obler?
Oh, yeah. You know the answer to that as well as I do, Frank. It's always after you've had your say for iron IGs.
Remember, friends, if you're deficient in vitamin B1 and iron, if that's why you're so under par in weight and strength and energy, then get ironized yeast tablets right away. Now, of course, a rundown condition may be due to other causes. If in doubt, see your doctor. But if you're simply short vitamin B1 and iron, remember, ironized yeast has been so successful in such cases that it's sold on this no-risk, money-back basis. If you don't begin to eat better, to look and feel much stronger, peppier, and more alive, the cost of the first bottle will be refunded to you in full by ironized yeast, Box IY, Rahway, New Jersey. Now, what is this about Sakhalin? Isn't that the Russian island up above Japan?
Yes, but our story concerns itself only about the Sakhalin, or Sakhalin, which was used as an execution ground, and it was a sort of a macabre education ground, and a devil's island against the enemies of the Tsar. It's a strange story of man's inhumanity to man in one of the strangest places this world has ever known. But be with us again, as usual, next week.
I hope y'all enjoyed tonight's episode. Check us out next time here at the Graveyard Shift with your host, Scott Nightshade. Y'all have a great evening.